title of my report is Quantum Collusion Attacks on Reduced Simpira V2. First, I introduce some knowledge of quantum computation, such as Groove algorithm, quantum random access memories, and some discuss with QRAM. Then, we introduce some of the techniques. The first one is Super S-Box, and the second one is Rebound Attack. According to those techniques, we can present the collision attacks on Simpira 2 and Simpira 4. Then, according to the quantum algorithm, we can pretend the quantum occlusion attack on Simpira 2 and Simpira 4. Now we describe the problem which can be solved by the Groove algorithm. Given a search space of 2 to the n elements and a Boolean function f, where f is given as a black box, found the only x such that f of x is equal to 1. In classical setting, we require about 2 to the n to find x. But in the quantum setting, Groove algorithm can be solved this problem, which needs about the square root of 2 to the n Groove iterations. Next, we introduce the definition of quantum random access memories. It is a quantum analog of a classical random access memory. Given a list of classical data L with x sub I, the QRAM for L is modded as a unitary transformation as follows. Therefore, we can access any quantum superposition of the data cells by using the corresponding superposition of addresses. For the time being, it is unknown how a working QRAM can be built. From another perspective, the absence of large QRAMs and the fact that a QRAM of size ON can be simulated with a QRAM circuit of size ON make it meaningful to conduct research in an attempt to reduce or even avoid the use of QRAM in quantum algorithms. Next, we introduce the definition of Simpira V2. Simpira V2 is a family of permutations that support inputs of 128 times B bits, where B is the number of branches. When B is equal to 1, Simpira V2 consists of 12 rounds AES with different constants. When B is greater than 2 or equal to 2, Simpira V2 is a generalized Bessel structure with a round function f that consists of 2 rounds of AES. We denote Simpira V2 family members with B branches as Simpira B. So, as shown in figure, it is a round function of Simpira 2. The round function f consists of an add constant operation and 2 rounds of AES, while omitting the add round key operation. Next, we introduce some of the techniques needed to find the collusions. The first one is the Super S-Box technique. As shown in figure, the target is to search for a pair of values whose difference satisfies the truncated differential from delta z sub 0 to delta w sub 2 from each of the 2 to the 32 differences at state z sub 0. Since the operation MC is linear, we compute the corresponding difference at state x sub 1. For each of the 2 to the 32 differences at state w sub 2, we compute the corresponding difference at state y sub 2 and store them in a list L. Then, given delta x sub 1, we search for a pair of values whose difference satisfies the differential trial from delta x sub 1 to delta y sub 2, where delta sub y 2 is belong to L. Here, we divide the search process into four parts that can all be computed independently. Each part contains 4 bytes, and we call the operation of changing the values of those 4 bytes from the state x sub 1 to state y sub 2 as a super x box. As shown in figure, one of the super x box is highlighted. From each of the 2 to the 32 pairs of input values to a super s-box at x sub 1, we compute the corresponding output difference, delta y sub 2. Similarly, we perform the same analysis for the remaining 3 super s-box. In the above program, both the time complexity and the memory complexity are 2 to the 32, and we can obtain 2 to the 32 pairs of values that satisfy the requirement. In the quantum setting, to apply the nested Grover's algorithm to compute the pair that confers to the differential from delta z sub 0 to delta w sub 2 with an additional time complexity of about 2 to the 16 without QRAM. The second technique is rebound attack. The rebound attack consists of an inbound phase and an outbound phase as shown in the figure. In the inbound phase, the actor efficiently fulfills the low probability part in the middle of the differential trial with a meeting in the middle technique. The degree of freedom is the number of matched pairs in the inbound phase, which will act as the starting point from the outbound phase. In the outbound phase, the starting points of the inbound phase are computed backward and forward through W sub BW and W sub FW to obtain a pair of values which satisfy the differential trial. Suppose the probability of the inbound phase is P, then we have to prepare one of the P's starting points in the inbound phase to expect one pair confirming to the differential trial of the outbound phase. Hence, the degree of freedom should be larger than one of the P's. In addition, our attack has a special property that the inbound phase consists of more than one inbound part. In the paper, we present the collision attack on Simpira 2 and Simpira 4. Firstly, we introduce the collision attack on 9-round Simpira 2, as shown in figure. In the inbound phase, the 2 inbound parts that happen in round 3 and round 5 are surrounded by the red dashed line and deduce the starting points by applying Super Xbox and Grover algorithm. In the outbound phase, propagate the starting points to the beginning and the end of the cipher to check if collide. In classical setting, if the probability of the outbound phase is P, then traverse one of the P's starting points to find the right one. In quantum setting, we can apply Grover algorithm to find the right one. The query complexity is the square root of one of the P's. For Simpira 4, the four branches are denoted as A, B, C, D. Collision A, B means the collision happens in branch A and B. A new 11-round derivation of Simpira 4 is introduced in figure, in view of which we built a series of collision attacks with any two branches. Next, as shown in figure, we make a slight change to the 11-round differential by attending one round before and peeling off its last round, and obtained a better differential trail for the condition attack on the last two branches. In the end, we summarize the results of the main attacks of Simpira V2. It is given in table. The first table is a summary of the result for Simpira 2. And the second table is a summary of the result for Simpira 4. That's all. Thank you for your listening.